seen Anushka Sharma talk about all of this in her interviews. Aaj tak baat karte hain. Deepika Padukone. No, yaar. It's not that.
Are you bitching out other actresses?
Never.
No.
No. They're all amazing.
Then I'm not interested.
यार भगवानों को याद करने के बाद भी भूत जाता नहीं है. तो हम बैठे हुए हैं, खत्म हो गई है, हम बाहर निकले नरेशन से. मैं मैनेजर बोल रही भूत पारसी होता तो Stop to multiple men. Don't put your eggs in one basket. I got comments saying कि इतना ही है तो घर से निकलते क्यों. I think that we do give love and relationships, like romantic love, a lot of unnecessary importance in our life. And I could see that she was handling it in such a empathetic way. I was obviously very angry at that man. कि अच्छा ठीक है, अभी एक हफ्ता पहले तुम मारने गए थे और अब तुम उसकी रिपोर्ट लिखवाने आए हो कि वो भाग गई. So important. Sometimes when you're not doing okay mentally, you feel like you'll be able to handle it all alone, or maybe people might not be able to understand कि क्या चल रहा है दिमाग में, तो नहीं बताते हैं. अब ये बचपन से है या ये दिल्ली वाला कॉन्फिडेंस है, क्योंकि दिल्ली में सब हीरो हैं.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to In the Ring with Filmfare. I'm in conversation with a powerhouse of talent. You've watched her in Kathal, you've watched her in scores of films, and of course, her path-breaking role in Dangal. I'm here to find out more about the life and times of Sanya Malhotra. Thank you, Sanya, for being here.
Thank you so much for having me.
So my first question to you is obviously about the kind of movies that you do. Is there some method in your madness?
I wish there was, but in all honesty, there's no method or no planning or even goal setting. I've stopped doing that. I used to set goals before Dangal, but as soon as I entered the... And into the party, I was like, I'm good enough. Like, there's no point planning my future.
It's, you know,
I want to live in the moment.
It's interesting. You're a dancer who was suddenly wrestling with the girls.
Yeah.
And what does that change like, you know?
That didn't work for me at all. For months, my coach used to shout at me, scream at me, scold me for pointing my feet. It was like, no, you're not supposed to look elegant. You have to look strong when you're doing wrestling. So, बहुत गालियाँ पड़ती थी.
I mean, you were more feminine while doing wrestling.
Yeah, and I have a habit. So, if you dance, you know, you have to point your feet. So, जैसे ही पैर ऊपर जाता था, तो I used to point my feet. It was like a ballerina doing wrestling, which obviously looks odd. So, बहुत. I remember हर दिन training के बाद. ट्रेनिंग पे तो आई यूज़ टू पुट ऑन अ वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग फेस, एंड जैसे ही कार में बैठते थे आई यूज़ टू ब्रेक डाउन, यूज़ टू क्राई अ लॉट कि मैं कैसे करूँ कैसे करूँ. बट ऑफ कोर्स एक साल रेसलिंग करो तो कौन नहीं रेसलर बन जाएगा. तो इट हेल्प्ड, आई थिंक ट्रेनिंग हेल्प्ड.
हाउ डिड यू, आई मीन यू नो, वन नीड्स टू बी रियली टफ टू वर्क इन दिस इंडस्ट्री. माय पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू कम्स फ्रॉम हाउ डू यू सॉर्ट ऑफ solidify yourself, strengthen yourself when you come from a place which is completely unfilmy. How do you handle your mental health issues?
I think in 2020, I took my first therapy. All of us were going through a lot.
Oh my God.
In 2020, and I think I was suppressing a lot of my mental issues, and my life kind of changed after Dangal as an actor. And I couldn't, and I'm very reticent, and I'm very shy, so I'm naturally introverted, but I had to, you know, I was not able to navigate in the industry well. I was being harsh on myself. I didn't like whatever I was doing. Koi bhi film aati thi, I used to sit back and really beat myself up for my performance, aur kuch galti kar di to uske upar sochte rehna baar baar, which was obviously not working for my mental health at all. And in 2020, I finally took therapy, and 2020 was even crucial because my films were releasing on OTT and we were still प्रमोटिंग द फिल्म. सो पहले तो मुझे इंटरव्यूज देते हुए भी ऐसा लगता था वो आई एम अनकॉम्प्रिहेंसिबल, पीपल कैन अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई एम सेइंग, आई एम नॉट मेकिंग सेंस. सो दिस वाज माय इनर डायलॉग थ्रू आउट एंड आई वाज लाइक आई कैन लाइक लीड माय प्रोफेशनल लाइफ विद सच लो कॉन्फिडेंस, आई नीड टू वर्क ऑन दिस. एंड आई टुक थेरेपी फॉर पर्सनल मैटर्स एज वेल, बट इट रियली हेल्प मी प्रोफेशनली टू. एंड आई थिंक द वन थिंग दैट रियली ग्राउंड्स मी is my family and the fact that I'm surrounded by people who are not from the industry. So whenever I'm not working, I'm not an actor. Like I don't behave like an actor, and I cannot kyunki ghar pe matlab डांट पिट जाएगी इफ आई एक्ट लाइक एन एक्टर अराउंड देम. एंड आई डोंट थिंक सो आई हैव इट इन मी, लाइक आई एम नॉट, आई डोंट कैरी दिस बैगेज ऑफ बींग एन एक्टर ऑफ बींग इन बॉलीवुड विद मी एट ऑल टाइम्स. एंड आई थिंक दैट really keeps me grounded in my personal life and professionally. Just that, I think in 2020 a major shift happened. I was keeping a lot of, because I live alone here in the city, so I was handling everything like alone, and I had developed this habit of not communicating anything to my friends, my family, assuming that I will, you know, be faltu mein unko kyun tang kare, I'll deal with it alone. So, and of course, it didn't help me at all. I was not in a good state. I was all alone in the city during the lockdown, which didn't help. And during the lockdown, after 3 or 4 months, I was cooking at 11 p.m. in the night, and I chopped my finger in the blender galti se. So I, at that time, I was like, shit, I wish I had my family around me. So luckily I live very close by to a hospital. So I rushed, a friend came and I got this operated. And after that, things kind of opened up. Uske baad Delhi chali gayi and I stayed there. And that's where I realized that it's so important. Sometimes when you're not doing okay mentally, you feel like you'll be able to handle it all alone, or maybe people might not be able to understand ki kya chal raha hai dimag mein, toh nahi batate hain. और ऐसा लगेगा कि ओ माई प्रॉब्लम्स आर नॉट प्रॉब्लम इनफ, लाइक इट्स नॉट लाइक बिग इनफ टू बी शेयरिंग इट विद एनीवन. सो मेरा वो इंटरनल डायलॉग रहता था कॉन्स्टेंटली. बट व्हेन आई स्टार्टेड लिविंग विद माई फैमिली एंड आई स्पेंड अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम विद माई फ्रेंड्स देयर, इट ईज्ड अप एंड आई रियलाइज दैट इट्स सो मच इम्पॉर्टेंट टू हैव अ कम्युनिटी अराउंड, टू हैव योर फ्रेंड्स एंड योर फैमिली, पीपल हु सपोर्ट यू एंड पीपल हु लिसन टू यू. सो yeah, it's been what, 4 years now. I take therapy regularly.
So there are like good days and bad days and all.
Of course,
that,
it's yeah. A part of life. Abhi good days chalte rahe to maza bhi nahi aata hai, kuch bad bhi hona chahiye.
But is it always personal related, or is it related more to the professional? You get anxiety, fear and all about the profession, or is it work related?
I have kind of detached myself from work. Now, I don't know. I'm still trying to understand, because I'm very like, haan, ho jayega, kaam hai. It's like a job to me. I don't take it too seriously anymore. Earlier, I used to. I do take it seriously in the sense that I have to work hard for whatever I'm doing. But apart from that, if something is not in my control, then I don't really stress about it. Whether it's a release of the film, I tend to like... now I focus on enjoying the whole process. I love promotions. I love giving interviews now, because mujhe lagta hai you get to meet so many people, you get to connect with them. Earlier I used to think ki vaiva chal raha hai, you teach. No, it used to feel like that. And in my therapy I realized I was so horrible at vaivas. But I was kind of projecting the same fear in my interview. और इंटरव्यूज में ऐसी हालत होती थी कि अरे क्या पूछ लिया, क्या नॉर्मल क्वेश्चन है, आप क्या दिन में खाकर आए हैं ये पूछ रहे हैं. सो दैट नाउ आई एम लाइक हाँ इट्स फन, इट्स चिल, काम है
ज्यादा रिलैक्सिंग. यू आर नॉट,
आई एम हैविंग फन, आई होप यू गाइस आर हैविंग फन.
यू मेंशनड बीइंग अलोन एंड इट्स इंपॉर्टेंट टू मी बिकॉज़ आई हैव फ्रेंड्स हु हैव कम फ्रॉम दिल्ली एंड दे टॉक अबाउट you know, feeling violated, being on the metro, and they find Bombay a much more safer space.
Hmm.
do you see the stark divide between the two places? I mean, in terms of, you know, as a woman, hmm. Do you feel more vulnerable? Do you, right?
I feel much safer here, definitely. Yeah. When I'd moved to Mumbai from Delhi, so काफी difference था. But ab, I think Delhi is also better.
Yeah. I remember you telling me once about being stalked by some 6 feet, some several guys who
in
chased
metro.
You in a metro and all that
horrible.
must be quite
daunting. And I used to take an auto to college, but that day I was like, I'm going to try metro. Why did I do that? It was a horrible. I remember at Rajiv Chowk, which is a bigger metro station, I called up my father crying. I was in the loo. I was hiding in the loo from them. These guys who started stalking me, and I called him crying, Papa, please, can you come pick me up from the metro station? And not that I don't use the public transport anymore, but the sad part is this can happen anywhere. The sad part is ki ye room mein sari auraton ne experience kara hoga, even being in Mumbai, I'm sure. Isn't it? They're all nodding.
Yeah, I mean,
it breaks my heart. It breaks my heart. It's not about Delhi and Bombay. It's just about, it can happen anywhere, sadly.
So, look at the toxicity in the industry. Recently, we saw an episode where a male actor just pushed the woman and she quickly recovered her wits and she was laughing. She had to, you know. So, sometimes do you think women themselves normalize this toxicity?
No. The thing is, they will be questioned. It's very, I sympathize with her, I empathize with that woman, because I understand ki agar, when you have made a person a demigod, like if they make a mistake, I don't think so everyone around them will be questioned, not them, you know? So it's very easy to say ki why are you not talking about it or react or say something or... should have retaliated. But it's very easy to say all of this. I remember when that interview where I'm talking about this metro incident, I got comments saying ki itna hi hai to ghar se nikalti kyun hu. So when you are getting such responses from people, then you think like ki hum share karke matlab kuch galti kari kya, matlab nahi nahi karte ghar pe baithe main apne logo ko pata hai koi baat nahi to chup hi rehte hain. तो ऐसा हो जाता है. इट्स वेरी इजी टू से कि ओ यू कुड हैव रिएक्टेड, बट इन दैट मोमेंट व्हेन देयर इज सो मच ऑन स्टेक एंड फॉर हर आई थिंक इट्स हर करियर, हर पीपल हु आर वॉचिंग हर ऑन स्क्रीन, देयर इज सो मच ऑन स्टेक. ऐसे बहुत इजी होता है बोलना कि व्हाई डिडंट यू रिएक्ट, या मुझे भी बोलना अरे तुमने कुछ करा क्यों नहीं, वो 6 फुट के लड़के को मार देना चाहिए था या कुछ करना था. ये बहुत ईजी होता है बोलना, पर वो उस मोमेंट में नहीं होता है.
But do you hear such similar misogynistic statements being made by co-stars or when you're acting in the... tell me one crazy statement.
I have. No, I don't think so. In Bollywood, we are not that tolerant. I don't think if this is in Bollywood, we would have cancelled that person, isn't it? Don't you think so?
When somebody would register their protest for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But true. I'm not saying that there's no misogyny.
Have you faced that?
No, I don't think so. No, I don't think so. I have. Have I? Let me think about it. Because it's a very big statement. Misogyny, we deal with it every
day.
So tell me. I don't remember. Maybe I must have suppressed it. Because sometimes you feel like, oh, there's no point talking about it. Who will listen? I'll go to my friends and tell them.
No, when also I'm connecting it to the kind of movies you do, whether it's Dangal, I'm sure, you know, people, wow, there's this father who wants to get his two, it's unheard of, right? You know, and even in terms of empowerment, if you see Paglet, you know, the woman comes into her own through another woman. So there's a lot of female empowerment, bonding, estrogen bonding that you say. And at the same time, say when you did a film like Kathal, okay, Kathal, let me get that right. When you played, did you meet other female cops, and did you see any kind of sexism within the police force?
No, actually, not there. And I was an MP when I was doing the research.
Okay.
I didn't see it there.
How do you get into the mind of a female cop?
But when I was there, when I met this particular police inspector for my research, we were in her cabin और कोई आया कोई तो मतलब कोई विक्टिम आया अंदर और दे वर कंप्लेनिंग अबाउट कि उसकी वाइफ भाग गई एंड शी स्टार्टेड स्क्रीमिंग एट हिम सेइंग कि पिछले हफ्ते वो आई थी ना तुमने मारा था उसे तो अब तो वो भागेगी बट देन शी इमीजिएटली स्विच्ड एंड शी वॉज लाइक अच्छा ठीक है आप टेंशन मत लीजिए हम ढूंढ लेंगे नाम बताइए एंड वो अपने बच्चों के साथ भी था तो बच्चे ऑल्सो स्टार्टेड कंप्लेनिंग कि ऐसा ऐसा हुआ और मम्मी भाग गई हैं और ये है वो है एंड आई कुड सी दैट शी वॉज हैंडलिंग इट इन सच अ एम्पथेटिक वे आई वॉज ऑब्वियसली वेरी एंग्री एट दैट मैन कि अच्छा ठीक है अभी एक हफ्ता पहले तुम मारने गए थे और अब तुम उसकी रिपोर्ट लिखवाने आए हो कि वो भाग गई सो व्हेन आई स्पोक टू हर अबाउट दैट पर्टिकुलर केस शी वॉज लाइक लिसन ही इज़ अ विक्टिम हियर ही इज़ वो एक हफ्ते पहले विक्टिम नहीं था एक हफ्ता पहले उसकी वाइफ विक्टिम थी बट वो आज हमसे हेल्प मांगने आया पुलिस से तो ही इज़ अ विक्टिम सो आई कांट कीप स्कोल्डिंग हिम फॉर व्हाट ही डिड वन वीक बैक सो आई वॉज लाइक वाओ लाइक वेरी एम्पथेटिक वे ऑफ डीलिंग विद सच अ सिचुएशन अगर मैं होती तो मैं तो उसी को डांटती रहती अच्छा और बताओ तुमने क्या किया बट यू नो यू दे आर वेरी इंटेलिजेंट दैट वे बिकॉज वो काफ़ी टाइम तो काउंसिल करते हैं लोगों को इन स्पेशली स्मॉलर सिटीज टॉकिंग अबाउट मिसोजिनी इन द इंडस्ट्री कभी कभार फील होता है कि पीपल मेक यू फील स्मॉलर
लाइक हाउ गिव मी एन एग्जांपल
छोटी छोटी चीजें द वे दे टॉक टू यू और द वे दे बिहेव अराउंड यू
यू थिंक द मोस्ट सक्सेसफुल यू आर द लेस सेक्सिस्ट और मिसोजिनिस्टिक आई डोंट थिंक सो
आई हैव सीन अनुष्का शर्मा टॉक अबाउट all of this in her interviews aaj tak baat karte hain to aisa to nahi hai ki if you become more successful things automatically get okay
what's the weirdest film offer that you've got
ha ek horror film aayi thi
was that film made ever
ha acha nahi mat nahi 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 aayi nahi
it's okay
agar aa gayi to mujhe nahi pata aur agar tum logo ne dekhi hai to please mat bolo so protagonist ke of course wo ghar mein jahan reh rahi hai wahan bhoot hai अब उसके हाथ में भूत आ जाते हैं ठीक और फिर वो पहले वो हनुमान चालीसा पढ़ती है तो कुछ नहीं होता फिर वो जीसस को बुलाती है कुछ नहीं होता फिर वो अल्लाह अकबर बोलती है कुछ नहीं होता बहुत भगवानों को याद करने के बाद भी भूत जाता नहीं है तो हम बैठे हुए हैं ख़त्म हो गई है हम बाहर निकले हैं नरेशन से मैं मैनेजर वॉज लाइक भूत पारसी होता तो ये तो कंफ्यूजन है ना ऐसे कैसे अज्यूम कर लिया उसका क्या रिलीजन है मेगा पॉइंट तो है और बहुत कुछ था शी स्टार्ट स्लैपिंग हरसेल्फ बट इट कुड हैव बीन सच अ नाइस मीम बिकॉज माय मैनेजर एंड आई माय एजेंट एंड आई kept laughing about it that this film is a good meme material ki haath mein bhoot aa gaya hai wo maar raha hai it's like one another slice of pizza no very funny it could have been a nice dark comedy yeah. like horror comedy
you know you had a run in with the paparazzi recently I mean a lot of female actors have told me sometimes they feel violated when they're coming out of gyms and they have not called the paparazzi there and you know they get what has been your experience I mean as a woman do you feel at all you know you recently had an incident while you had gone to vote so what's been your take
I stepped out and I think it was a bit chaotic they were blocking the road सो आई थॉट कि रोड क्रॉस करके फोटोज़ कर लेते हैं बट इन दैट केओस दिस कैमरा मैन केम एंड ही वॉज अबाउट टू हिट मी ऑन माई फेस बट इट्स ओके लाइक पीपल गॉट रियली एंग्री व्हेन आई पोस्टेड इट बट आई फाउंड इट वेरी फनी बिकॉज आई डू बॉक्सिंग एंड बॉक्सिंग में डॉज करना होता है एंड आई हैव डन दिस सो मेनी टाइम्स फॉर 4 years आई हैव बीन बॉक्सिंग फॉर लाइक 5 years नाउ मोर देन दैट So I got very happy when I saw it in slow motion. I was like, "Oh my God, I have to show it to Tridev, my trainer." like, but people were very angry
yeah.
with it. Ki punch bhi karna chahiye tha. But it's okay, you know. It's they're doing their job, and I feel very sad for them. Like, in this horrible weather, they have to stand outside. the restaurants, offices, to get like one picture of these celebrities. So I feel for them. I know most of them. They're all very sweet boys. But I feel sad if other actors feel not safe and violated. But the thing is, I have a very different take on it because I hardly step out of my house and get clicked. I do go to the gym, but I never get papped there. Thank God.
Because you don't call them there.
I don't call them there. That's true. And I'm always looking so bad. मुझे यही डर लग रहा होता है. जिस दिन मैं बहुत खराब लगती हूँ तब मैं जरूर पैप होती हूँ. तब मैं सुम्बुल को भी बोलती हूँ कि सुम्बुल आज ही का दिन मिला था. Whenever I get ready, whenever I wear like makeup and good clothes and I'm stepping out, I never get clicked. Only when I'm in my pajamas. I got clicked in my pajamas recently. I'm stepping out of Buji and I'm in my pajamas. Damn. Otherwise, if I'm looking good, I never get clicked. If I'm looking कि अब भी उठ के आई हैं बेड से सीधा उस दिन मैं जरूर क्लिक होती हूँ.
What did you learn from your previous relationship? So clearly you're single right now. That's what you're saying on camera.
Yeah.
But
I am.
Okay. Yeah. So what did you learn from from your previous relationship, from your last relationship?
Last one was a situationship.
I'm too old school. You have to explain the situation.
So situationship is not a relationship.
Okay.
And it's not even a dating. Is it a dating phase? Yeah, you're dating that person, but you're still figuring it out.
Okay.
They're like, na idhar ke, na udhar ke.
So what did you figure
Beach
out?
Beach ke. I figured out that situationships are not for me.
Yeah.
Never doing that again. When you like the person, then you like them, then you go into dating them. Don't like keep hanging in between. That
doesn't work. So situationships
are
not for you.
Not
for me. So what do you look for in a relationship? Like, what are the do's and don'ts in a man? You know, there'll be many people wanting to date you. So they want to know what they would like.
I'm very ambitious and I'm also very independent. So I naturally get attracted to men who are ambitious and independent. Independent in the way that they have their own universe around them. Because I have a very strong circle. I have my family, my friends. And if they also have that, I think we can both come together and form our own world. You don't have to be codependent on your partner for everything. For emotional support, for... like not for physical support. Physical support, please stay with your partners. But if you are into other things, then good. But
so you can't date multiple people at the same time.
No,
you can't go out on
I can't multitask. Matlab, I can't do like normal things that people usually do, like multiple things at one time. So dating multiple people at once is not.
Not
going to happen. Can't do it.
So you're one of those, what do you say?
I'm very loyal. Even if I'm talking to someone, if I'm going out on a date with someone for the first time, then I will only talk to that one particular person. And my friends keep telling me, don't ever do that. Talk to multiple men. Don't put your eggs in one basket. I'm like, how? How is that possible? Nahi ho sakta.
Matlab, you're a star. You must be hit on by so many people. So many
not
people
at all.
I want to see your DMs on your Instagram.
Please,
what is the
go
kind
through
of
it.
DMs you get?
Kuch bhi nahi. Bahut hi kharab kharab. Really sad ones. Nobody has ever slipped into my DMs ever.
So how does a pretty girl successful, is it that you intimidate men, or how do you date then? How's it possible? Don't you meet like a hot person on the flight? Don't you meet a hot doctor? Don't you meet a hot investment banker? Who are
no,
where the people? Where
I've
are the
only met like really old but nice men in flight. Uncles. Yeah, I met someone who was in his 60s and wo abhi date karna kisi ko start kiya unhone after he got like he got out of a relationship and in his 60s he found his cool friend and they're dating now. So I get to meet like such old men who are already in a relationship, married, have kids in the flight.
So is there
no
meet
cute moments?
No,
never.
How can that? That's almost unnatural, right?
Is it?
You can't have met anyone in the last 5 years. Unless you obviously don't want to say it for camera.
No, I have. As I said, I've been like situation. I have been in situationships. I've been out on dates. But how do I explain? I'm not actively looking for a partner right now. Like I think that we do give love and relationships, like romantic love, a lot of unnecessary importance in our life. It is important too. But I have found my platonic relationships to be very fulfilling. So I'm really enjoying that right now. My last relationship was for 5 years. Usse pehle 4 years. So for when you're dating for so long, I think you kind of neglect yourself and your platonic relationships somewhere. Like that happened with me. I'm not talking about everyone else.
You ignore
else,
your
but
friends and all of that. Yeah.
And I have been in like codependent relationships, which was not healthy for me and my partner. I'm friends with all my exes. All my exes.
Possible?
Kaise? Do hi log. It
possible
is possible. You can like be pally. You don't have to be best friends with them. But yeah, we are friends. That works for me. But
would you
I
date
have...
an actor?
No.
Have you dated an actor?
Never.
Okay.
I cannot.
Why?
As I said, it could also be because the people that I surround myself with are not actors and they're not from the industry. So I'm kind of used to that and I like listening to their stories and what's going on in their world, because when you're with a Bollywood person, they only talk about Bollywood. They only talk about the industry, assuming that this is the world. Mumbai is the only world Bollywood. That we live in. Bollywood hi hota hai. Set pe kya chal raha hai, kaun actor kya film kar raha hai. I find it very boring.
You don't gossip.
I don't gossip. I cannot gossip. Like only kabhi aisa
no,
lagta hai ki
hard to believe.
You ask my friends, they're like, kuch batao. Kuch hai hi nahi. For batane ke liye, I'll have to step out of my house. I hardly do that. And I keep, I don't do.
Who are your actor friends?
Anant, my co-star in Kathal. He's okay. Fantastic. He is also a flamenco dancer. He's in Spain right now. Him, Radhika, Fatima, they all have like, you know, life apart from being an actor. And that's very attractive. I think I feel very glad that I am surrounded by such people who have a life apart from being an actor, because this can consume you. Being an actor can be the only and the most important part of your life. And
yeah.
I think I was kind of heading towards that. And this is in 2019, where my work was the most important thing in my life. I was not spending enough time with my friends, my family. I was constantly working. And I used to take pride in that. Ki main bahut busy hun, I'm burned out, I'm not sleeping. But I'm working so hard. To what? Like, at the end of the day, as an artist, you need to step back. You need to live life. You need to meet people to be inspired. I think all of the experiences that I am having, apart from being on set, helps me and in my job, helps me become a better actor.
You mentioned Radhika and you mentioned Fatima. I mean, it's very interesting because I seldom see heroines bonding, because obviously everybody's doing the probably dating the same guys, probably going out and vying for the same roles. But the names you also mentioned are very interesting. Radhika, Fatima. Do you think women, of course, are each other's best friends? Obviously, there are times, but they also can be each other's worst enemies when triggered wrongly. Is there something like that?
I have amazing female friendships in my life.
Talk about it. Let's.
I feel very secure. I feel there's a sense of empathy when you're around women. Not just that, a sense of sympathy when you are around women. We do understand each other in a very deep way, isn't it? We all have wonderful women around us. I hope you all have.
Everyone's quiet.
Very strong. Girl gang?
Yes.
Sab nod kar rahe hain, thank God. Good girls. Nahi hai, to dhoondo.
Like,
you will find your tribe.
What's the conversation you have with Radhika or Fatima? like weird, zany, mad, crazy.
With content. Radhika, it's all Bollywood. She only talks in dialogues. So, वो कोई डायलॉग बोलेगी तो मुझे याद करना पड़ेगा ये कौन सी फिल्म का है, इसका जवाब कैसे है, फ्रैक्स ऑक्सीजन फ्रैक्स शॉट्स, तो याद करना पड़ता है. एंड देन शी आस्क आल्सो कौन सी फिल्म का डायलॉग है, तो यू हैव टू बी वेरी क्विक विद हर. लाइक इट्स ऑल अबाउट दैट एंड ऑल्सो अबाउट स्पिरिचुअलिटी एंड विद हर इट्स अबाउट एक्टिंग एंड हर एक्सपीरियंस ऑन अ सेट एंड आई शेयर माई एक्सपीरियंसेस विद हर
बिकॉज़ वी वर्क टुगेदर. व्हाट्स द क्रेजीएस्ट थिंग राधिका'स डन, यू नो, बिकॉज़ शी सीम्स इन अ नाइस वे, शी सीम्स लाइक क्रेजी एंड
शी इज वंडरफुल एट गिविंग गिफ्ट्स.
ओके,
सो हर बर्थडे गिफ्ट्स आर नॉट जस्ट लाइक अच्छा ये मैं स्टोर से लाई हूँ हैप्पी बर्थडे. शी, हाउ डू आई एक्सप्लेन, लाइक शी रियली पुट्स इन अ लॉट ऑफ हर ओन क्रिएटिविटी इन मेकिंग अ गिफ्ट. Like, she once gifted me a record player because years back I told her when we were shooting for Patakha ki I want a record player, and she gifted me a vintage one which she found in like Chor Bazaar or somewhere.
Cute.
So she's very, she really cares about her friends and her family and the people that she is with. So that with Fatty, it's all very this thing ki haan aur kya chal raha hai Fatima, aisa sort of relationship, you know, because and I feel
so. Do they
so,
seek you out for relationship advice and all that?
No, none of us really talk about all of that.
No.
Actually, Radhika do.
Yeah.
Sometimes I feel like I need to stop because she really listens to me and I feel scared. Ki kabhi
kuch galat. She'll end up single.
In the same boat. That, but with Fatty, yeah, it's also about work, but we are very secure in that way because we started our careers together. So it just fits, I don't know, like, there's a sense of security and this bond that we created for so long. We were preparing for Dangal for what, almost 1 year. We all used to live together.
Mm.
So it feels like a family, you know. Ki abhi, if I'm leaving the city or the country and if I'm going and there's no one to take care of my cat, so Fatty takes care of her. So oh, it's like that. Even if we don't meet regularly, but we still have that, you know, bond with each other.
You know, it's interesting that even such roles, such topics are explored or, you know, like the Vishal Bhardwaj film, the kind of bonding and the kind of, you know, you're married to brothers and all of that. So has there been a real life switch? Have you ever felt, oh shit, ye maine experience kiya hai? Ya, in among all the films that you've done, has there been anything like that?
Paglet. I showed it to my parents in a special screening before the release of the film.
Mm.
So my mother saw it and of course they really liked it. But after the screening, she told me that something like this has happened with someone that we know. Someone I'm very close to. And very similar to Sandhya, she too found photos in her husband's closet when he passed away. And I was like, oh my God, damn. And after the film got released and when she saw it, I called her up and I asked her like, did you like the film? And she said, yes, and it's so relatable. Like, this has happened with me too. And she told me that she still has those photos.
What's the worst piece of advice that you've got and the best piece of advice that you've got?
To not take a break and to keep going. These are your years. Why do you want a vacation? Why do you want to take a break? Make the most out of it. Karte raho kaam. Kyun karte raho? That's the worst kind of advice I've ever got. And I did that. I think I listened to that person. I was like, okay, I have to do as many films as possible. I have to block my ears and keep working back to back. Luckily, I do that because I get really good opportunities. But I think I do know that it's so, so important to rest and take time off work. And especially when you're doing all of this, you know, you're constantly surrounded by people, you're getting out, getting in and out of a character. I tend to carry some emotions home when that are not mine and my characters. So I need to take a break from that for sure. And the good one would be to wait. Like, Rome was not built in a day. My father keeps saying that. He used to keep telling me that when I had moved to Mumbai. तो कभी कभार ऑडिशन का कॉल नहीं आता था या अब तो ऐसा था कि अभी इफ आई डोंट गेट एन एड और इफ आई डोंट गेट अ गिग हाउ विल आई पे माई रेंट सो माई फादर यूज टू टेल मी दैट लिसन रूम वॉज नॉट बिल्ट इन अ डे यू स्टे देयर लाइक हैव पेशेंस
यू नो योर्स इज ऑल्सो अ जनरेशन विच लिव्स थ्रू इंस्टाग्राम यू नो फिल्टर्स स्नैपचैट व्हाटएवर 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 which is not real, right? And there is also a conditioning. I mean, you talk about girls are constantly wooed, bombarded with images of Botox, fillers, the perfect holiday, the perfect vacation, the perfect body. The ads show it too. You know, there's an entire cosmetic conglomerate which says the perfect body, body shaming. Do you get asked to do Botox, or do you get asked to do fillers, or do you get asked to, you know, do stuff like that? And how do you sort of, do you go on a social media detox? Because it just gets too much. Like, you know, sometimes when I'm scrolling for about 2 hours at a stretch, and, you know, it just gets, I start getting very anxious. And then I put the phone, overwhelmed mm-hmm. is more than anxious. I put the phone away for about 8 hours. And then I feel, you know, okay, better.
Hmm.
So, but you as actors, you know, I'm sure your managers say, put out your best picture, put out your brand thing. So it's a constant thing. You wake up in the morning, okay, how do I increase my numbers? How do I increase my followers? So is that a thing with you? The two parts of my question. One is, of course, the body part, which, you know, somebody will say, nahi aap naak dekh karo ya jaws. Have you been told that? And have you ever sort of vaguely succumbed to any kind of criticism?
No.
But have you been told stuff like that?
Yeah, of course I have. Someone told me that your lips are very thin. Like, whenever you smile, I can see your gums. Like, isn't that supposed to happen when you're smiling? Your gums should be seen, right? And I think she sensed it. Like, I got very upset with that comment. So she was like, no, I mean, like, whenever you're smiling, so you practice, okay, in front of the mirror, you stand and you pull your lip like that up to train your lip to go up whenever you're smiling. And I was like, damn, like, we need to stop telling women and commenting on their body, about their features. There's enough like things out there to make you feel bad about yourself. Like, you do not have to, like, I felt very, I don't know, I just felt, I didn't even feel, I was very angry at her. And I also am very secure and very confident with the way I look.
You're lovely.
I know. Thank you. But no, ye bachpan se hai ya ye Delhi wala confidence hai. क्योंकि दिल्ली में सब हीरो हैं सब आप निकल जाएं दिल्ली में सब एक्टर्स की तरह ही घूमते आप मार्केट जाएंगे तो फुल इन लाइक फुल हेयर एंड मेकअप देन नेवर नॉट अंडर ड्रेस्ड दिस इज माय दिल्ली कॉन्फिडेंस सो व्हेन आई मूव्ड टू मुंबई आई यूज्ड टू गो टू ऑडिशंस विदाउट हेयर एंड मेकअप
या
लाइक हां दे विल कास्ट मी फॉर माय एक्टिंग so much nothing wrong with makeup I love makeup but jahan acting ki baat aayi to mujhe laga I don't know the character yet so maybe I'll go without hair and makeup focus on the part and then we'll decide how the character should look like and I have always nailed all my auditions I've gotten most of the ads that I have auditioned for so whenever people comment on my body I judge them like I'm like oh no I feel like, oh, maybe they are not secure enough in themselves to be commenting on someone else and their appearance. That. And for women, our bodies are changing every day. इन ऑल आर फेजेस. ओव्यूलेशन में कुछ और लगते हैं, लूटियल फेज में कुछ और. आई एम गोइंग थ्रू माय लूटियल फेज, आई एम गोइंग टू गेट माय पीरियड्स वेरी सून, सो आई ब्लोट, आई पुट ऑन लाइक 5 kgs, देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ वाटर रिटेंशन, माय बॉडी लुक्स डिफरेंट. सो आई हैव गॉटन ओके विद दिस एंड आई एक्सेप्टेड फुली कि ये माय बॉडी इज ऑलवेज चेंजिंग. इन अ मंथ आई गो थ्रू फेजेस. व्हेनेवर आई एम ऑफ माय पीरियड्स आई हैव एब्स. 10 दिन बाद चली गई. फिर 10 दिन बाद नहीं आई है, नहीं आएंगी तो कोई बात नहीं. कांट स्टॉप लिविंग माय लाइफ. आई ईट वट एवर आई वांट टू ईट. आई डू गेट योर पॉइंट दैट व्हेन पीपल सी दीज ओवर प्रोसेस्ड फोटोज, वेल क्यूरेटेड इंस्टाग्राम डंप्स ऑनलाइन, sort of kind of feel like, अरे why am I not on a vacation? Why don't I look like this woman who has done 20,000 things on herself and on top of it also edited their photos. Good for them. Whatever makes them feel secure. But yeah, like there should be a boundary.
But you that. you go through a social media detox and stuff like that.
हर दिन, एवरी डे इज अ स्ट्रगल विद सोशल मीडिया. बट माई थिंग इज दैट आई डोंट पिक अप माई फोन टिल 11:30 AM. सो आई वेक अप वेरी अर्ली, आई गो प्ले टेनिस, आई वर्क आउट, आई कम बैक, प्ले विद माई कैट, थिंक अबाउट लाइफ, गेट एंशियस. देन आई नो इफ आई
डू व्हेन यू गेट एंशियस,
देयर इज अ एंजाइटी रिलीफ म्यूजिक. I don't know if people know about Huberman, right? Huberman Lab.
Okay.
This scientist guy who has a podcast. So I follow his page. So he recommended this music. So nowadays I'm using that. For music is also not helping.
Tell me, have you called out your parents ever? Like, you know, in their traditional roles as husband and wife. As a daughter, have you said, no, this is not right. This is not, have you done that?
Constantly with my papa.
Yeah.
I love him. But I can get very annoying with him at times.
Yeah, like give me an instance.
Like sometimes when he doesn't step into the kitchen and gets himself a glass of water. Like he waits outside for mamma to go pour him a glass of water and I feel very angry. घर पे होती तो मैं सुना देती हूँ, पापा अंदर जाओ, पानी लेकर आओ खुद से. Like extra steps, 10,000 steps every day. चलो वैसा. But that and I think it's also after doing Mrs. I've gotten more, you know, I observe these things more now.
Yeah.
Because the film is about that.
Well, congratulations on Mrs. She's won the Best Actor Award at the New York Film Festival.
Thank you. Thank you.
So, to give you a small overview, Mrs. is the remake of a Malayalam film called The Great Indian Kitchen. And I recommend that you first watch the film before you watch. I don't know when Mrs. will be out.
Soon.
It's an outstanding take on marriage, and you know, a woman is married into a very misogynistic, toxic, patriarchal family. So beautiful, and I'm sure she's done a fantastic role. This thing, so please watch that movie, it's amazing. So, yes. What did you do? You have to, did it make you angry doing that film?
Yeah, it did. And I interviewed a lot of women for that character. I know someone very close who has been through a very similar sort of relationship, and very graciously that friend of mine shared her therapy notes with me. So I used to go through her therapy notes, and so detailed, every day before my shoot. And after that, you know, we shot the film linear, and so my character really got the time to really build those emotions.
Did your friend walk out of that marriage?
Yeah, she did. And we were shooting in one location, and at one point she's only in the kitchen, so I felt very trapped, felt very uncomfortable, used to cry almost every day on set. just thinking about my character, thinking about Richa and what she's going through.
Well, I'm done with all kinds of inquisitions with you. Let's take some questions from the audience if they have. So please raise your hand, anyone who wants to ask a question. Yeah.
So we all love your dance.
Thank you.
On social media.
Mm-hmm. In real life too, I dance really well. Not just for the camera.
Are we going to see you in a dance-themed movie?
Dance-themed movie? Hopefully soon. I think I'll have to write myself a script. Yeah, I have a few ideas, but I might take some time off of work and write a script, like a dance film. Hopefully that works. Please dekh lena.
Hi.
Hello.
Which one's the better, Mumbai street food or Delhi street food?
Delhi! Golgappe, chaat, dahi bhalle, chole kulche.
If you could choose between working again with Shah Rukh or Aamir Khan, who would you choose?
Wow, that's a tough one. Both?
Both?
Haan.
Pick one.
Both? Khan. Bahut sunne ko mile agar ek ka naam liya to. Deepika Padukone.
Hi, I'm Kehkasha.
Hi, Kehkasha. Such a beautiful name.
Thank you. So we heard that the Jawan girls have a group chat. Is it still active?
It is. It was Priya's birthday yesterday. So I think they're planning to meet on Sunday.
So what's been the craziest conversation on that chat?
Can't really talk about that.
Come on, one of the conversations. You'll discuss boys, you'll discuss...
We have other things. No, yaar. It's not that.
Are you bitching out other actresses?
Never.
No?
No. They're all amazing.
Then I'm not interested.
Exactly. I did a podcast with Urfi recently and she's like, tumne itna kharaab kar rakha na mahol Bollywood ka. Sab friends bane hue ho, koi gossip nahi deta. koi cat fight nahi kar raha. It's so boring. Which is true. Mere side se to koi aa nahi rahi hai.
Anyone else? Yeah.
Hi, this is Rahul.
Hi, Rahul.
You said you are in relationship with 5 years, 4 years. So what is that one worst thing you must have done, being in love?
Aisa kuch nahi hai, main badi normal hoon.
Are you over-possessive? Are you demanding?
No. I've only been in long distance. Never main Delhi se hoon. Koi karke dikha. I'm actually very... I'll be like, okay, it's okay now. You leave. Never going to see your face if that happens.
So you take a while before you get back to being friends with them, right? You let the water flow on the bridge.
No. I'm actually, yeah, whatever. You also have to ask the other person, whatever they want. Like if they'll be comfortable or not being friends. It's not like I'm imposing on them that we are friends, no? I want to know whoever you are dating. No, you're never going to get a breather from me. It's not that. Friends in the sense that it's not like I'm talking to them every day or every week. Sure. But yeah.
Healthy
space.
Anyone else?
Yeah.
Who would be your punching bag if you have to share something, or what could your movements that I have to share something with this person always?
Anjali, my best friend.
Who's the artist? Okay.
Very funny story. She's actually very famous, okay? I was in London. So we went to this fast food place. We ordered and the girl behind the counter kept looking at us and smiling. So we placed our orders. We came outside. We sat on the table. That thing those restaurants give, na, it started vibrating and my friends were like, go, she's your fan. Ja, mille jaake. I went inside. I asked that girl, hello. she's like, listen, is that Anjali Mehta? And I'm like, yes. Because I'm a huge fan. I went back and I was like, listen, she's your fan. Go get the order. But I was so happy. I feel very proud of her. She's amazing. She's so talented. She deserves all the recognition that she gets for her art.
Amazing. So here's to more wonderful friends, wonderful performances, and a wonderful you. Thank you so much for being in the conversation.
Thank you. Thanks a lot, everyone.